Hello everyone and welcome to Ron TV Metro. How is your day going? It's a nice sunny Monday morning here in the Philippines and we're gonna do a short walk. Later I have some plans that I have to get into later, so this is just gonna be a short walk, just maybe explore a couple of streets or a few streets, and then we'll see what we can get into, shall we? Yeah, let's go and check out the neighborhood again. I actually did a couple of videos yesterday, but it didn't go out the way I want it to be. So if I'm not satisfied with the video, I'm sure you guys won't too. So I want to do a video that's that I know you guys would love, you guys at least would like. And if you do like this video, please give it a like, share, and subscribe. Hey, that's a first for me, starting with those, right? So we are gonna check out a few streets. I'm not gonna go through the major thoroughfare right now. I'm just gonna show you guys some side roads near my place. Like I said, I have a plan later, so I have to get back fairly quickly to my place. So here's Hazelnut Street, and I'm on Betelnut Street. I've shown this in a previous video when I was doing it manually. Try to cross without getting run over by. So yeah, it's very sunny. It's about, I'm guessing, 30 degrees. And it's still very not that late in the morning, probably mid morning. That car comes, no, motorcycle coming. I'll let this motorcycle pass first. So, yeah, well, at least now you can see some of the sari-sari stores now just opening. Usually open around 8 in the morning, 8, 9 o'clock in the morning. So it's, you know, there you see, because it's Monday, start of a work day, so it's getting a bit busy. As you can see, the bank parking lot is kind of full right now. So many motorcycles. Here's the Il Fernando Avenue. This way. There's a bank delivery truck, so I might be able to cross now. Look at that, the Urbanist Orange Corolla. Again, if you don't know the channel, it's Urbanist Exploring Cities. Check them out. It's basically the major YouTuber that inspired me to get into this kind of stuff, and I'm quite enjoying it. So we'll take on some side streets. No really, no subject really. Just to get a good walk today. Plus, you know, the other day I had a fisticuff with the fruit salad, and quite frankly, the salad won. So this is Dragon Street. There was actually a Filipina actress comedian who lived near here, but you know, she was, if I'm not mistaken, she was part of the Philippines, maybe vaudeville. I could be wrong, but maybe vaudeville, sort of vaudeville kind of actress. That patch is a bit wet. Gonna make sure I don't have any vehicles coming. Let's go across here. I hope I'm not doing it the same way the last time I was videoing it. So here you got continuation of Dragon Street there. We're gonna circle around this block, and then I'll end the video once I get back on the other side. So cross our fingers, things go well here. Maybe I'll stick to the other side because it's quite hot here. There's a new, didn't know there was a new building here being constructed, but not sure what's for, but you know, lots of new businesses coming out. At least that's a good thing, because the policies that are currently being implemented are crappy, to say it mildly, you know. Which also reminds me, because you know, while I may be able to film later at the mall that I'm going to, for the next maybe 1 or 2 weeks, filming in malls might be tricky for me because of some new policies being implemented that I totally disagree with. Again, my position is that people should not be discriminated for the choices that they make in their own lives and their own bodies. So, and you know, everyone deserves the normality everybody has. There shouldn't be like division to that. And I totally disagree with some of the policies that are being brought about by you know who. So yeah. So I may not be able to feature a lot of mall interiors, but we will see what happens. I'm still very hopeful. I hope you saw that train, because I kind of saw the back end of it. Oh, here's another, what we call it here, the small body Corolla. Yeah. Well, there, I lost my train of thought, so I apologize for that. Let's go this way. I hope I'm treating this video quite well. I hope I'm not stepping on dog landmines. So the other day I was trying to film, and it was too sunny, too hot, and that the video just didn't go out that well. But today I'm a bit more motivated to film. As you can see, it's very busy here because it's Monday. Yesterday, this was like, this parking lot was empty. So, got some shops here. This area used to be like the place where you get your driver's license, but they transferred to a different office, so I'm not sure where they are right now. Man, it's really hot. I'm gonna take a left here and circle back. Let's let this biker pass by first. Here are the tricycles that you've seen the videos of my tricycle ride, so these are the ones that I usually take. On one of my tricycle rides, actually, I did pass by the street, so if you go straight here, you'll end up out on Marcos Highway, and that's another train, I think. So let's see if I can see it here. Yep, I see it. There you go. That's the Light Rail Transit, LRT. It starts from the heart of Manila, and then it goes out here to the eastern side of Metro Manila. Just to give you an understanding of Metro Manila, because that's the difference. Manila is basically one of the cities within the greater Metro Manila. Metro Manila is comprised with, like, I believe 16 cities. So 16 small cities, and then, yeah. But it's also still, basically it's the national capital. So it's kind of like New York having like Brooklyn, Bronx, Queens, Staten Island, Manhattan. So kind of like that, but 16 times. But the size is probably in the, I don't know, maybe Manhattan. So yeah, we're gonna continue on here. And there used to be a primary school here. I'm not sure whether I don't think it's operating anymore. Well, I might cross because it's really hot. It's really, really hot. So just gonna check out. Slow down. That car was going way too fast on a very tiny street. I don't know. There are crazy drivers all over the place. That scared the crap out of me, honestly. I may have done a little number one. Oh shit, dog. Shit, shit, dog, come on. Let's go here. There's just a dog there. Didn't realize there was dogs here. And somebody should really complain about that, because it's illegal here in my city, in my town, to leave a dog like that. So I don't know. I don't know. I guess during this situation in the world, people are disregarding laws left and right. But that's not, you know, that's not right. So maybe I'll, I don't know. That's a big dog too. I mean, I like dogs. I used to have a dog. I miss my old dog. He was a nice dog. And not that small either. His name was Jack. Oh, how I love that dog. But, you know, I believe he was a mixture of a poodle and a Japanese Spitz. I don't know. I can't remember the, I can't remember his exact breed, but yeah. So you may have noticed that there are like small bags on the sidewalk. These are garbages. It's garbage day today, so they are just waiting for the garbage man to pick up, the garbage truck to pick it up. Whoa, what happened there? What happened at work? That S-Class, and it's an S-Class. It's an S-Class, man. I mean, have some respect to the car. So this is just a short stroll. This neighborhood is called Midtown. So it's not Midtown Manhattan, but Midtown Subdivision. Yeah, so there are places here that are called subdivisions, villages. My place is a subdivision. That's how we distinguish it, because there used to be like privately owned places turned into housings. Here's some of the places here. Anyways, folks, I'm about to end. As soon as I get to the avenue, if you haven't, please give this video a like, share, and also subscribe to the channel, and also check out my old videos. I know they are all non-gimbal videos, so it may be maybe not as good quality as this one, and I hope this one is actually is in good quality. But do check them out. I do have some very nice features there as well. I'd like to thank again my friends Jan Patricio, Richard Saras, and Fernal Luzas for this generous gift of the gimbal, because without them, you know, I wouldn't be doing this. Yeah, so we're going back where I came from, and this is where I'm gonna end my video. Please, I hope you guys enjoyed it. So as I cross this very tricky intersection, give this video a like, share, and subscribe. I'll see you folks on the next adventure. Bye.